Hi everyone, welcome back to this video on how to add a custom toolbar with annotations and form fields to the React PDF Viewer component. Look at this example, the PDF viewer rendered with custom toolbar with the options to add annotations and form fields. Now, I am going to show you how to add annotation and form field options to the PDF Viewer toolbar. First, let's explore the steps for integrating the custom toolbar with annotations into the React PDF Viewer component. In this React PDF Viewer application, I have already added React PDF Viewer component with necessary toolbar modules. If you want to know how to add PDF Viewer component to React app, you can check the Getting Started video linked in the card above. Here, I have integrated a custom toolbar into the React PDF Viewer, providing options for navigation, magnification, zoom, text search, and selection. To learn how to implement this custom toolbar with these options, check out the video provided in the description below. I am running the application using the command npm start. You can see the PDF Viewer component rendered with custom toolbar for file open, navigation, magnification, and text search. Next, let me add the annotation option in the existing custom toolbar. To do this, I will import the annotation module and inject it. In the primary toolbar, I add an annotation button that allows you to interact with and add various types of annotations to the PDF documents. Since I'm going to include various sub-options in the annotation option, I added the secondary toolbar. In the secondary toolbar, I am going to add first item as text markup annotation. The PDF viewer provides various text markup annotations, including highlight, underline, and strikethrough. To add text markup annotations, let me add three toolbar item tags with appropriate properties. To enable the highlight option, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, using the PDF viewer instance, I will call the method setAnnotationMode and pass highlight as an argument. Similarly, I use the setAnnotationMode method to apply underline and strikethrough annotations, passing corresponding text markup type parameters as arguments. Following that, I will add the condition to display the annotation secondary toolbar by setting the display property to block. Look here, you can see the annotation option shown in the custom toolbar. Clicking on this button will open a secondary toolbar that contains the text markup annotations. Using text markup annotations like highlight, which is used to highlight the text, underline any text using underline option, and strike any unwanted text in the PDF file. Next, I am going to add shape annotations to the existing toolbar. The PDF viewer provides various shape annotations, including line, arrow, rectangle, circle, and polygon. To add measurement annotations, let me add five toolbar item tags with appropriate properties. To enable the line shape option, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, using the PDF viewer instance, I will call the method setAnnotationMode and pass line as an argument. Similarly, I have done the same for the remaining shape annotations with corresponding shape type parameters as arguments. Using these shape annotations, I can add line, rectangle, and polygon in the PDF document. Next, let me add measurement annotations to the existing toolbar. The PDF viewer provides various measurement annotations, including distance, perimeter, area, radius, and volume. To add measurement annotations, let me add five toolbar item tags with appropriate properties. To enable the calibrate distance measurement option, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, using the PDF viewer instance, I will call the method setAnnotationMode and pass distance as an argument. Similarly, I have done the same for the remaining measurement annotations with corresponding type parameters as arguments. Using these calibrate distance measurement annotations, I can measure distance, area, and radius over the pages of the PDF document. Next, I am going to add free text annotations to the existing toolbar. To achieve this, let me add a toolbar item tag with the appropriate properties. To enable the free text annotation, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, using the PDF viewer instance, I will call the method setAnnotationMode and pass free text as an argument. You can add the free text annotation while click on this button. Next, let me add stamp annotation in the secondary toolbar. PDF Viewer provides three enum types of stamp annotations, which is dynamic, sign here, and standard business. And import the stamp names. To add stamp option, let me add a toolbar item tag with the appropriate properties. Then, I define the function named stamp template. Within the function, I use Syncfusion EJ2 menu component and import it. To add menu items, I define a variable called data which holds JSON data for supported stamp annotations. Then, I assign this variable, data, to the items property of menu component. I enable show item onclick property to open menu items and submenus on a menu item click. After that, I trigger select event and define the onItemSelect associated function. Within that function, I retrieve the menu and submenu item text by ID and innertext property. Using this value, I distinguish the type of stamp annotation. To add revised dynamic stamp annotation, I have added a condition that if the menu stamp annotation type is dynamic and its submenu item is revised, I call the setAnnotationMode method and pass the two arguments, stamp and dynamic stamp item, as revised. I follow the same procedure for the remaining dynamic typed stamp annotations. To add witness sign stamp annotation, I have added a condition that if the menu stamp annotation type is sign here, and its submenu item is witness, I call the setAnnotationMode method, and I pass the three arguments, stamp, undefined, and sign stamp item as witness. I follow the same procedure for the remaining sign here type stamp annotations. Next, I will add the condition to check whether stamp item is standard business and its sub item is approved. Then I will call setAnnotationMode method and pass the arguments. I done the same procedure for the remaining standard type stamp annotations. If you click the stamp annotation drop-down button, a drop-down pop-up will appear and show the stamp annotations to be added. You can drag and add the item where you want to place the stamp on the PDF document. Next, let me add signature to the existing toolbar. The PDF viewer supports two signature modes, such as handwritten signature mode and initial mode. To add signature annotations, let me add a toolbar item tag with appropriate properties. To accommodate this, I have created a separate container for the signature with a drop-down list consisting of two items and respective styles named Add Signature and Initial. Next, I trigger the onClick event handler and define the onSignature click function that is associated with it. In the onSignature click function, I retrieve the signature text by innerText property. In the onSignature click function, I add the condition that, if we want to add a handwritten signature mode, I call the setAnnotationMode method and pass the argument as handwritten signature. This allows the user to draw a signature using a mouse or touchscreen. If we want to enable the initial signature mode, I call the setAnnotationMode method again, but this time passing the initial as an argument, which allows the user to add their initials as an annotation. Following that, I will add the condition to display the annotation secondary toolbar by setting the display property to block. If I click the signature annotation option, the signature container button will appear. You can select and add the signature where you want to place it on the PDF document. Next, let me add ink annotation to the existing toolbar. For this, let me add a toolbar item tag with appropriate properties. To enable the ink annotation, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, I call the setAnnotationMode method and pass the argument as ink. You can draw any text by using the ink annotation. Next, let me add the Form Fields module in the existing custom toolbar. To do this, I will import the Form Designer and Form Fields modules and inject it. In the primary toolbar, I have added a Form Field button that allows you to add various types of form fields to the PDF documents. Since I'm going to include various sub-options within the form field choices, I added the secondary toolbar. To add the text box field, I will add a condition in the switch case of the click handler function. Then, I call the setFormFieldMode method and pass the argument as text box. Similarly, I have done the same for the remaining form field types, passing the corresponding value as an argument. Following that, I will add the condition to display the annotation secondary toolbar by setting the display property to block. Then, I enable the interaction of form fields in the PDF viewer. To add form fields, I use a form filling document for better clarity. Clicking on this button will open a secondary toolbar that contains the different form fields that you can edit the form fields in the PDF document. You can simply drag and drop the desired form field to the location where you want it to appear on your document. Next, let me add signature form fields to the existing toolbar. For this, I use the same signature toolbar as we already defined for the signature annotation. In the onSignature click function, I retrieve the signature toolbar and check whether its visibility is enabled. If it is enabled, I add in condition that checks if we want to add a signature field. I call the setFormFieldMode method and pass the argument as signature field. If we want to add an initial field instead, I call the setFormFieldMode method and pass the argument as initial field. Then, I have handled the condition to differentiate between the annotation signature and the signature form field. Following that, I will verify the condition wherein clicking the signature form field will cause the secondary toolbar to become visible. You can add the signature field to the location where you want it to appear on PDF document. In this video, I have demonstrated how to add a custom toolbar with annotations and form fields to the React PDF Viewer component. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in the description below. Additionally, I have included a link in the description that you can use to check if you qualify for our community license, which provides a free license key for our entire React component suite. If you found this video helpful, please remember to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching.